Everyone, welcome back. So this time we are going to discuss about Ethereum. And if you know what is blockchain, you must have heard the term Ethereum as well. So let's go a little deeper and understand what exactly it is. Let's begin then. So let us quickly go to the agenda of today's video. So first of all, we'll be talking about what is Ethereum, followed by smart contracts, and then features of Ethereum. We'll also see a case study, and also we'll see a hands-on exercise on this particular platform. And finally, we'll be talking about the career opportunities you can have in this particular domain. So let's begin. So today, most of our data or passwords or let's say financial information are actually mostly stored on cloud and servers, which are again owned by companies like Amazon, Microsoft or Google, right? So this setup has a number of advantages, as these companies deploy teams of specialists to store and secure this data and eventually remove the costs that comes with hosting and uptime. But with this convenience, there's also vulnerability, as we have learned that a hacker or a government can simply gain unauthorized access to your files without your knowledge by simply influencing or attacking a third-party service, meaning they can simply steal, leak, or change our important information. So what do you think? What has to be done to avoid this? And the answer to this is Ethereum. Yes. Ethereum is one of the newest technologies which uses a blockchain to replace internet third parties, those that store data, transfer mortgages, or keep track of complex financial instruments. So what is Ethereum? Let's go a little deeper. Now, Ethereum is an open software platform which is based on blockchain technology that enables developers to build and deploy decentralized applications. It also provides a giant network of the users on computers. So the simplest way to think of Ethereum is as a programmable Bitcoin. Now, Ethereum allows participants to run decentralized blockchain applications, which are called smart contracts. Now, these smart contracts are highly secure and run with a perfect digital history, making them auditable, transparent, and immutable. So these smart contracts can be programmed without any chance of downtime, censorship, or fraud. Now the Ethereum blockchain and smart contracts form a shared global supercomputer that can simply move value, represent ownership, transmit tokenized assets, and digitize many more complex real-world applications. So this lets developers create markets, shared ledgers, digital organizations, and many more things that have not even been invented, and all without a middleman and all immutable, much like what the internet did for the information. So Ethereum has a power to open up the financial system to the world and build a safer, more accessible and fair economy for literally everyone. So like Bitcoin, Ethereum is a distributed public blockchain network. So both Bitcoin and Ethereum are often compared to each other, but the two were designed with different visions and goals. Now, Bitcoin is a widely used system for, let's say, generating a shared world ledger that securely records Bitcoin balances. And on the other hand, Ethereum again uses many of the same systems in order to generate a shared world computing platform that can flexibly but securely run any application users want to code. So for you guys to understand, let us take an example of Slockit. So it is a German startup specialized in blockchain and IoT applications, which are moving to realize the vision of smart contracts embedded in IoT-enabled devices. Now the company will sell smart locks linked to the Ethereum blockchain. Okay, when someone purchases a lock, it will be connected to the lock smart contract in the Ethereum blockchain and controlled by it. Now the owner of a lock can set a deposit amount and a price for renting his property. And then the user will pay that deposit through a transaction to the Ethereum blockchain, thereby getting permission to open and close that smart lock through their smartphones. Now the deposit will be locked in the Ethereum blockchain until the user decides to return the virtual key by sending another transaction to the Ethereum blockchain. Then the contract will automatically be enforced, and the deposit will be sent back to the user minus the price for the rental, which will be automatically sent to the owner of the lock. So all of this actually happens without any assistance from any third party. And all this mechanism is carried out using Ethereum smart contract. So now that you know how actually it works, let us also list out some of the features of Ethereum. So the main features of Ethereum are cryptocurrency, smart contracts, the decentralized autonomous organization, and smart property. Now, Ethereum is a blockchain-based implementation, and it requires a form of the monetary system. So it has its own internal cryptocurrency called Ether. Now, it has also got a concept of smart contracts, which is basically an application that would run on blockchain and process all the information present on the blockchain aspect. Then the third feature is decentralized autonomous organization. So it works with popular cryptocurrency and digital ledger operations that many businesses are moving towards the transparency. It also includes this concept of smart property, wherein anyone could digitally transfer their property without having to face any of the hassles for exchanging the property or validating the documents. So recently, over 30 large corporations such as Microsoft, Intel, ING, and JP Morgan Chase formed the Enterprise Ethereum Alliance, which is EEA. So these corporations are actually building technology and decentralized applications on the Ethereum blockchain. JP Morgan, one of the biggest American multinational investment banks. So they are also using blockchain technologies as tools to improve the global economic system. So in one system, they were looking for a payment originator for payment beneficiary, a payment originator for the banking system, and a payment instruction to the distributed ledger on a peer-to-peer network, and finally, the payment originator for bank internal system. And to achieve all this, the organization opted for Ethereum technology. So this ambitious project actually covers both on-chain and off-chain payment processing, allowing customers to healthily and smoothly migrate their systems to Ethereum technology through JP Morgan. As a result, JP Morgan's business strategy increases its investment spectrum, and its vision would allow a considerable improvement not only in the provided services but also in its daily processing capacity. And now let's check out how actually does it work. Okay, so in this particular portion, I'm going to tell you guys that how you can actually send or receive or buy or sell ethers using this particular Ethereum platform, right? So for sending or receiving ethers, you need to have one wallet added to your extension, Chrome extension. So this is the wallet that we are using, and we are calling it metamask.io. So you simply need to go to this particular domain, type in this domain, and then you need to type in here, get Chrome extension. Once you type in over here, you'll be led to this page. Now, since I have already got this added to my Chrome, and that is why it is giving me the option which is added to Chrome. But for you guys, it will be like add to Chrome. So you simply click on this add to Chrome and then just follow some security procedures. And ultimately, this would be added to your Chrome just like this. Okay, so this is a wallet. So there are again many other wallets that can be used for sending and receiving ethers, but I'm going to use this one. So this is our wallet. Let me open this one. Now, what are these? Though I have already talked in detail about all this in my previous video, which was based on smart contract, you can also find the link of the same video on the comments below. But again, to give just a little bit of brief about it. So this is the main Ethereum network where we actually deploy our smart contracts, right? And all these are test networks. So basically developers use it. So whenever they have to just test it, you know, about how is it functioning, how your code is functioning. So you use all these networks. So right now also, to, you know, for a test purpose, I'm going to use this Roopston test network. So see, I've already got this much of Ether, right? So first of all, we need to, you know, send or receive Ether. So for example, if I need to send this much of Ether to someone else's account, so for that, I need to have Ether in my account. So I have already got it, but for you to got this Ether in your account, you simply click on deposit. So here, test faucet, get Ether. Let it get open for us. Okay, so here you can click as many times as you want. I mean, the number of ethers you want to be deposited into your account. And then it is going to take a few moments, you know, while the ether gets deposited to your account. So till then, let me explain you guys some other features of it. So for example, let's say I need to transfer, let's say 4 ethers from my account 1 to someone else's account. Now see, it has become 11. So the ether has been, or all the ethers that I actually clicked over there have been deposited to my test account. Now, for example, if I need to send, let's say 4 ethers to someone, then I need to know the account address of that particular person. Now, let me tell you something, guys, that here as well, you have got 2 keys
Right, one is public, one is private. So let me take an example of bank account. It's not that I'm relating banking to Ethereum blockchain, but just to make or give you guys a clear concept of it, I'm taking this example. So for example, in bank account as well, when you have got net banking, so you've got two things. One is your bank account number and another one is what? And another one is your net banking customer ID. So whenever you need to make any kind of transactions, like if you want to send some money or receive some money from someone, so you always tell the person your bank account number and never your customer ID number. In this bank scenario, this bank account number is actually your public key, which you can share with anyone if you want a particular transaction to take place. However, your customer ID is your private key, which you are always advised not to send with anyone. So the same happens in this case. If you want to make any transaction, so this, see, this is the ID which has been copied. So this is my public address, which I can tell anyone, right? So for example, if I need to send some money, so let me again create one more account. Let's say I have created account 2 already, but for you guys, let me create one more account. Let's say create account and just create it. So see, account 3 has been created and this is the public address for account 3. Now let's go back to account 1. And now let's say I want to send some amount of Ether. So let me click. Now I'm sending it from account 1. This is my public network. This is the amount of Ether, you know, that is there present available in my account. Now from account 1, let's say I want to send to account 3. And that is why it is asking me recipient address. So right now it is account 3. I've clicked on it. Now amount of Ether that you want to send, let's specify this. Let's say it's 4 Ethers. And then you can simply click on next. Okay, so of course, from account 1 to account 3, how many ethers? This many ethers, which is worth of this many of your fiat currency, right? And I'll confirm it. Okay, so it is again going to take a while, so that the transaction can take place. So this is how actually you send it. And let us just wait for a while so that it will get deducted from account 1 and will get deposited in account 3. So see, we have got the confirmation stating transaction 3 confirmed, view on Etherscan. So now here also you can see now I'm left with only 7 Ethers, 4 Ethers have been deducted. If I go to account 3, then see, 4 Ethers have been deposited in account 3. So this is how you send your ethers, right? Or receive ethers. Now, this is what? So this is actually telling me the status of my transaction, which is confirmed, right? So let me click on that. So see, this is nothing but the ether scan. So whenever you have made any kind of transaction on Ethereum blockchain, so you can see everything, all the history on ether scan. So this is the particular transaction that I just made. So the ID of that particular transaction, that is hash, is nothing but this. Now status is successful. So this is the block under which I performed this particular transaction. Timestamp, one of the very important feature of blockchain. So it is going to give you exactly when this transaction took place. That is what it is showing. And then this is the public address I was talking about, or public key, you can see. So this is the from account. So from this account to this account, the transaction, has been taken place. And then how, what was the amount that I transferred? So that was 4 Ether and all those stuff. So you can get actually all this information over here. So this is a particular transaction, right? But if I go to Etherscan, let me show you guys. Okay. So Etherscan, again, as I told you guys, that blockchain actually supports a transparent nature, right? That is one of the major features of blockchain, or let's say Ethereum blockchain. And that is why it is very much transparent. So even if you do not have any kind of account, or you do not use blockchain or anything, just you as a viewer can simply go to Etherscan and check what all is happening in this world. Exactly. So here, these all are the transactions, right? So for example, let me go on the top. So this is the recent block which has been mined by this particular person, and then in reward he has, or the this particular club actually has got this much of Ether. And then under this block, 57 transactions have taken place. And if I click on this, see, you can see every transaction, every single transaction over here. Let me go back and just click now. So see, all these transactions have taken place under this block, right? That was it was showing now recently. It has become now 84 transactions. So here actually each and every detail you can simply get. That is what I wanted to tell you guys. So this is a particular transaction and this is the entire world of transaction. So whatever you want, you can simply go and check it out. So this was all about how do you actually send or receive Ether, you know, on this Ethereum platform. But then if you want to buy or sell Ether, then for that you need to go to an universally exchange platform. So for that, let me again go back to main Ethereum platform and here deposit. So see, this is Coinbase, which is the world's most popular way to buy and sell Bitcoin, Ethereum, etc. So we are going to use again this one only because that's universally and most popular way to, you know, exchange the ethers. So continue to Coinbase. Okay, so here it's very simple. So you simply write the amount, for example, let's say 1,000. Okay, so for 1,000 rupees, you want to, you know, create or establish the transaction. So you'll put the amount over here and then you're also mention your email address over here. And then by email, you'll be getting the status of your transaction. Now, let me tell you guys how it actually works. So for example, if you want to sell, let's say 2 ethers, so you'll give a request in the pool of requests that you want to sell 2 ethers. I mean, just by giving the amount fiat currency over here. And then in the same pool of requests, there must be someone who might be needing 1 ether. I mean, who might need to buy 1 ether or 2 ether. Then your request would get matched with that person's request and the transaction would take place. And then you'll be informed using your email ID. So that is how this actually, you know, happens in this particular pool of request. So whatever fiat currency is there for that much of Ether, you'll be getting that. And this is how it works. So that's how it's very simple. So for buying and selling, you use this platform, this exchange platform. You mention your amount, you give your email address, and accordingly, then the Ethereum platform or exchange would take care of itself and would let you know the status of this transaction as and when it would happen. So this was very easy, friends, and I hope you get an idea about how do you actually, you know, send, receive or sell buy Ether on this particular platform. Now let's go ahead. So I hope you've got a fair idea about, you know, how this platform works and what are the uses of Ether and so on. So now let's move ahead. So these decentralized applications of Ethereum can actually disrupt hundreds of established industries, just like finance, real estate, insurance and so on. So considering the trends and advancements in the technology, it's safer to say that the prospects of Ethereum as a platform seems bright and this is the right time to start your career in this field of blockchain and Ethereum. So thousands of opportunities are actually awaiting you. You can simply be a blockchain Ethereum developer, an Ethereum architect or an Ethereum designer. So if you wish to learn Ethereum and build your career in blockchain technologies, you can simply visit our blockchain certification training course today. So Intellipaat Ethereum blockchain training helps you in understanding the fundamentals of Ethereum blockchain, Ethereum smart contracts and cryptocurrency, and also designing a private blockchain with Ethereum, and finally solidity language for implementing smart contracts. And with this, we come to the end of this video. Now let me summarize what we discussed in today's session. So first, we started with the importance and definition of Ethereum. Then we moved on to Ethereum smart contracts through Slock example and Ethereum features. We also saw a demo video on Ethereum and finally a case study on JP Morgan. And at last, we discussed career opportunities in Ethereum blockchain. So thank you so much guys for watching this video, and if you have any query, you can simply contact us anytime. I hope the video was informative for you. Please like the video and if you have any doubt, comment below. We shall respond to it at the earliest. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more such informative videos. Do look out for other related videos in our playlist. For more detailed information, visit our website now. Have a great day and career ahead.